Hello everyone, I hope you have already watched a video of laterally unsupported beam that I have shared with you. But the problem is, in that particular video they have used the IS code IS 800 of previous version, but we need to know how to use the current version, that is IS 800 2007. So let us come to that. So here you can see the clause number 8.2.2, that is for laterally unsupported beam. The first few lines, if you read it here, you will get to know that if you consider this, if you get this particular three conditions, then you no need to consider the beam as to be laterally unsupported, because in case of a laterally unsupported beam, you will be having lateral torsion. If you have a lateral torsion buckling, then your structure or beam, your beam will be failing at a pretty lower value than compared to a laterally supported beam. So it is part you can study by yourself, but the only few things that I want to give stress upon is this particular formula. So in case of a laterally unsupported beam, as we know that its bending moment, a design moment, or you can say the resisting moment of the particular beam will be less than a laterally supported beam. So what is the value? So how to calculate the value? The value of the particular beam or laterally unsupported beam can be calculated by this particular equation. Md is equal to beta b zp into fd. So let us see what are these particular values are. So what is beta b? Beta b is equal to 1 for plastic and compact sections. I have already shared with you the PDF. If you go through, sorry, PPT. If you go through that PPT, I think you will see the different sections, the compact sections, the plastic sections. So for plastic sections and compact section, it is 1. And other than that, the beta B value should be taken as ZE into ZP for semi-compact sections. Okay. So what is ZP? ZP is the plastic section modulus, and ZE is the elastic section modulus. These values you will get it from the steel table, or in the annexer of this particular code also you will get this ZP and ZE value. These are the section moduluses. Then what is FB? FB is a design bending compressive stress. It is a design bending compressive stress. So what is the, how much of bending stress it will have? Then these values can be obtained from table 13A and 13B. Now the equation that is given, the FBD is equal to chi LT FY by gamma M naught. So what is chi LT? Chi LT is a bending stress reduction factor to account for lateral torsional buckling, given by, the equation for chi LT is given by 1 by phi LT plus phi LT square minus lambda LT square to the power 0.5, and this value should be less than 1. And what is phi LT? Phi LT is given by this equation. So here I think alpha LT and lambda LT, these two values are unknown to us. So alpha LT value is given from here. So what is alpha LT? It's an imperfection parameter given by alpha LT is equal to 0.21 for roll steel section. What is roll steel section? Like this, the whole section is directly casted from the molten steel, suppose directly ready-made sections of I section, C section. These are ready-made sections. Whichever ready-made section you will get, these are the cold steel sections and weld roll steel section, and the welded section that you, if you're welding, it's like gantry girder, plate girder, like that. So for welded sections you will having more imperfection, so phi LT value is more. Lambda LT is given by this particular equation. You can see here beta B ZP FY MCR. So what is MCR? This is a critical moment. Okay, we will see how the critical moment should be calculated. So you can see that everything is interrelated. So if I want to find out lambda LT, because if I want to find out chi LT, you need to find out lambda LT first. Lambda, to find out lambda LT, we need MCR first. But to find out MCR, we have another equation over here. Now, as you can see here, to find out lambda LT, we have two equations basically. We have to check for both. We have to find out from this equation root over beta B ZP FY by MCR. And now we have to, you can see here, you can, what is FCR? To FCR, to find out FCR, there is one equation, this one. But also we have another table for that, that is table 14. So let us see what does the table 14 says. Yeah. So if you see this table 14, it gives you the critical stresses Fs here. You need to find out KL by R value and H by TF value. So H by TF value is you will get it from the section dimensions, and KL by R, that K is the effective length, K interval is the effective length, R is the radius of gyration. You can find out easily. So there will be Rx and Ry. So you can find out KL by R and H by TF, and from that you can find out what is the FCR value. Either you can follow this particular table, or you can use this particular equation to find out. Use this particular equation to find out what is FCR value. So I think the use of table is very much easier for you. So you can use that particular table to find out FCR. Then you can find out lambda LT, and use this lambda LT to find out chi LT, then use chi LT to find out chi LT, and then finally you can find out FBD. But if you see here, you can skip this process, whole process, by only looking at this particular table 13. You can see if for chi LT value 0.21, if FCR value is already known to you, for a particular value of FY, you can find out FBD value. So you can directly go to the calculation of FBD. Always remember, if anywhere you are stuck, you are not getting the exact values, you have to interpolate that particular values. So either you can follow these particular equations, or you can find out directly from the table. I think I will advise you to once at least you should try using this particular equation to find out what is the FBD value. Now let us see what how if you see this particular clause, that is 8.2.2.1. We have three equations to find out MCR, MCR and FCR. So this particular, the first equation, if you see, this particular equation is for prismatic members with symmetric cross section. Okay, in case of simply supported, in case of a simply supported member, prismatic member and symmetric cross section. And but this particular equation is a simplified version of this. You can see here GI and all are not there. So this is for simplified equation. This is prismatic member made of standard roll I sections and welded doubly symmetric I sections. So these are for only I sections which is symmetric. In both the symmetric roll sections you can use, but I will suggest you to use only this particular equation. You can use it if you are very pretty sure that this is a roll section and a standard I or standard roll I section or doubly welded doubly symmetric I section. Other than that, you can, in general, you can use this particular equation to come up to find out the value of MCR and FCRB. You can also find out FCRB from the table 14, as I have already shown you. Now, what is the value of LLT? So if you see here, what is LLT? It is the effective length of lateral torsional buckling. Just like buckling of column, you have effective length. Similarly, as we have lateral torsion buckling in beam, we will be having a effective length for lateral torsion buckling. So let us see how we can find out it from table number 15. So let us find out table number 15. Yeah. So these are the torsional restraint, okay? And this is the warping restraint, the condition of restraint at support and loading conditions, so normal and destabilizing. So for fully restrained in torsional, fully torsional restraint, if it is fully torsional restraint and warping, if both the flanges are fully restrained, top flange and bottom flange, then you can use this one. If it is torsion, if it is torsionally restrained, but the compression fell only with the, in the warping case, only the compression flange is restrained, then you have to use this one. I would advise you to go through this particular clause, that is 8.3 for calculation of effective length. You go through it and try to understand how to find out the LLT. So this is for today. Just if you have any doubt, please let me know and try to solve the problem or the assignment that I have given you. And also refer for this particular problem, you can refer to the book Design of Shield Structure and Subramanian. So this is for today. Thank you.